I want you to write it down. I'm going to give you a quick review, very fast, on curses and blessings. Write it down. I taught you on what is a curse. So I gave you, and I'm going to repeat the causes, you know, for you to have the causes. Because sometimes we ask ourselves questions. Why this curse is operating in my life and I'm not being free? So I want you to see the causes: idolatry, false gods. Number two, dishonoring parents. When you dishonor parents. Number three, illicit and anti-natural sex. Four, injustice to the weak, to the poor, and the widow. Five, trust in men more than God. Six, promise something to God and then withdraw from it. In other words, backing up from it. You promise a pledge, a covenant, or an offering to the Lord, and you backed up from it. That brings a curse. That's what the Bible says. Or any promise that you have made to God. Number seven, to steal the tithe and offering. Steal the tithe and offering from God. Number eight, curses pronounced for men that represents God. For example, if your father cursed you, that works. Why? Because he's an authority. He represents God. When a pastor curses one of the members, that works because he represents God. Is it right to do? Of course it's not right. I'm telling you why a curse can come. Number nine, there are many people right now operating under a curse because your mother cursed you when you were little. And that curse is still operating in you. How do you be free from curses? What are the steps to be free from curses, from any curse operating in your life? John, Galatians chapter 3, verse 13. What is it?
Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangs on a tree.
Okay, now I want you to understand something. In the cross, there was what I called an interchange that took place. Jesus took our curse for us to be blessed. That is the thing of the cross that you need to know and have revelation of it. Okay, tell me, Frankie.
Apostle, this is a great testimony. He can tell you in a few words, but it's basically over five generations of witchcraft that were broken over his life, and he's been serving God for over 21 years. So there is over five generations of witchcraft that were broken. And this young man, Pastor Daniel, that's his name, Apostle.
Wow, can you put your hand, come on! You're gonna rejoice. Five generations.
Praise the Lord.
Your ancestors, your grandfather, well, tell me, just a little bit.
Yes, born and raised in Suriname. We were in the interior. And my tribe, we have the chief. We have a different tribe. We have 12 tribes in the interior. And my tribe, we have the chief. And people will come from all over the Caribbean for witchcraft in my family. And basically, people are afraid in the witchcraft because of my tribe, of their witchcraft practice. And thank God for His grace, His mercy, and His love that He took me out of that witchcraft. And He
had lived. Tell me, to tell the people, how many generations?
That was five generations.
Tell me, how was it? Your grandfather, your great-grandfather?
Actually, it started back from the runaway slave in the interior. And these people practiced from my great-grand.
So you're what generation, what number?
Five.
Five.
Yes.
Now, what are you doing now?
Now I'm preaching the gospel because I've been set free by the Lord Jesus Christ. And I went back to the interior. I went back to the interior and started a church in the interior. And these same people who were practicing witchcraft came to the Lord. Most of them came to the Lord.
Awesome. Put your hand together. What happened over here?
Pastor, this is Sammy. Since he was small, his uncle introduced him to pornography since he was a little boy. And because of that, he started going to the occult to be free. He would wear rings of astrology. He would have his hands red. He started doing all these occultic things. He could not be free. For many years, he struggled with it. When he came to Jesus Christ, he understood the revelation of being set free from this curse that came from his uncle. And now he's been completely free for over a year. He doesn't struggle with that anymore. And God set him completely free from that. He doesn't go to astrology. Jesus broke that curse over him.
Okay, how many generations?
Pastor, my uncle introduced me to it. I remember that one summer he came to my house and introduced me to masturbation. And right after that, Pastor, it took control of my life. And to the extent that I used to get up in the night and I lost control over my life. And I was so desperate. And when I realized that I get caught into something that I have no hope, and I was so ashamed and I'm so scared that I couldn't share that with my mom and dad. And I start going out, I start going to people who do the astrology and all that, and they say, could you help me, please? Could you help me? I used to go to temple, pay them money to deliver me. Yeah. But every day it was a struggle. And I lost hope to the extent that I thought that I'm never going to come out of this. But God has mercy over me. He brought me this far. He brought me this far, and he delivered me. By the blood of Jesus Christ, I'm delivered. I'm delivered. Completely, I'm free.
Completely
I'm
free.
Free.
Awesome. Put your hands together. Come on, people.
And give Jesus a big praise.
Apostle, over four generations of drug abuse, crack, cocaine, you name it. Over four of them.
Four.
This young man, by the power of the cross, he said, I make a decision that what they have been through, I will not have to go through it. He's been completely delivered by the power of God.
Tell me, how do you feel now?
I am overwhelmed with what God has done in my family. My grandmother, my great-grandmother, all started with alcoholism. I saw the process start with cigarettes, alcoholism, and then it progressed to crack cocaine. My mother was on crack for 20-something years, and we prayed for her, and one day she said, you know what, this is it. And since then, she has not touched crack another day in her life. My sister, I have a sister, my oldest sister, on crack. I had the opportunity to raise her children. As it goes, my family, each generation has had to been raised by another generation. So my niece lived with me, and I declared over her life, you will not be a crackhead. You will not experience drug and alcoholism. And she's been delivered. My sister has been delivered from alcoholism. So we're just believing that God,
four generations,
my God, he is able. He is able to do exceedingly abundantly, you know, and
know,
above.
You know, son, when you're telling this, you know, kind of testimonies, that is the Word becoming flesh. They're not people watching by television. By the way, there are 90 million of Hindus watching. And there are people watching in all over the world. And they're saying, how can I be free from a curse of alcohol? And this is what people can describe it. The same that happened with my father is happening to me. So give him a word to those people for 30 seconds.
The Lord wants you to know that by the power of his might, by the power of his blood, you can be delivered. You can be set free. He is able. He is the one in control. He has the authority, and he has given it to you. Walk in it, my brother. Walk in it, my sister. You have the power of the Lord Jesus. It was done on the cross for you, and walk in it today. I command you in the name of Jesus, be free, be made whole, be made whole. You are, and you have it. Walk in it in the name of Jesus. I command you right now. The Lord God loves you, and he says he wants you to come to him. Come to him. Receive him now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Come on. Now, there are many theologians. They are saying, yeah, but that's emotional. Well, how many years you have been free from that curse?
I have been free since the age of 15.
So how many years?
I am 38 years old.
That emotion has lasted that long.
I made a decision that I would not be what they say I'm going to be. My family said to me, you're going to be just like your mother. And I said, devil, you're a liar. I am a child of the King, and I'm seeking him, and that's who I'm going to be like.
Come on!